student, today we are going to discuss chapter 13, ratio and proportion. Exercise 13.3. In this exercise, we know how to use three methods. How can we solve any problem with the help of three methods? Ratio and proportions. We already defined it in previous video, you can see, and here we are going to discuss three methods. So first we take one questions. First question is that if the cost of 4 pencils is 8 rupees, find the cost of 7 pencils. Okay, so in this question, this is given cost of 4 pencils. We write here cost of 4 pencil is equal to rupees 8. So because we are going to solve it by three methods, so first you find the cost of 1 pencil. So how can you find the cost of 1 pencil? You will write cost of 1 pencil is equal to rupees 8/4. If you divide 8/4, then you get rupees 2. It means that the cost of 1 pencil is 2 rupees. Because in this question, this is given that the cost of 4 pencil is 8 rupees. So you need to find the cost of 7 pencils. So for this, first you find the cost of 1 pencil. Okay, so here you can see we find the cost of 1 pencil is 2 rupees. So you can write again cost of 7 pencil pencils is equal to what? 7 rupees 2 into 7. Cost of 7 pencil is equal to rupees 2 into 7. So 7 to the universal 14. So if you find the cost of 7 pencil is equal to 14. So then I hope all of you understood this question. And here you find the cost of 7 pencil is rupees 14. Okay. You can also solve it directly here, or you can solve it. Cost of 7 pencil in one line, cost of 7 pencil is equal to the cost of 4 pencil is 8/4 into 7. 7 become 4 to the 8 and 7 to the 14, or rupees 14 in one line. So you can solve it. Okay, but here you use three method to solve this question. Also you can solve this question like this. Okay, now the second question is given here in this exercise 13.3. I hope all of you understood this question. In this question, a cost of 4 pencil is given, and we need to find cost of 7 pencil. You can also find cost of 10 pencil and whatever. Okay, so here we need to find cost of 7 pencil, and the cost of 7 pencil is given here 14 rupees. This is clear. Now the next question is given here. If a 6 notebook cost rupees 45, how much would 8 notebook cost? Okay, so in this question, this is given the cost of 6 notebook is 45 rupees. So what is the cost of 8 notebooks? So let's see how to find this question. Okay, so in this question, this is given that the cost of 6 notebooks is given here 45 rupees. So we need to find cost of 8 notebooks. So first, here we write cost of 6 notebooks is
45 rupees.
Here question number 2. Cost of 6 6 notebook.
Sorry.
cost of 6 workbook is given here. 6 and notebook is 12 rupees 45. Okay. Cost of 6 notebooks given here 45 rupees. Okay. So we find here cost of 1 notebook. Cost of 1 is equal to 1. Cost of 1 notebook is equal to, you write it 45 by 6, because the cost of 6 notebook is 45 rupees. So cost of 1 notebook is equal to what? Cost of 1 notebook is equal to 45 by 6. This is clear. So here you need to find cost of how many notebook? 8 notebook. So you write cost of 8 notebook is equal to what? Cost of 8 notebook is equal to, you can write here 45 by 6 into 8. Okay. So if you simplify this, you obtain rupees 60. Okay. You can find 60 rupees of the cost of 8 notebook. So here if you cancel it, 2 3 6 and 4 2 8. Now here you can see 15 and 3 45. So we have here 15 into 4. This is equal to what? This is equal to rupees 60. So at last you can write cost of, here write, therefore cost of 8 notebooks is 60 rupees. Okay. So student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss next question. Question number 3 of this exercise. Question number 3 is that a man earns 75,000 rupees in 5 months. A man earns 75,000 rupees in 5 months. So question asked to us, how much will he earn in 9 months? How much will he earn in 9 months? And next question is asked, in how many months will he earn 4,50,000 rupees? So let's see how to find, how to solve these questions. Okay. In how many months man earn 45,000 rupees? Okay. So let's see. First we arrange the opposite, we solve this question. In second part of this question number 3, the asked number of months that the man earned 45,000 rupees. Okay. So first we write question number 3 here. And in this question, this is given that in 5 months a man earned 7,005 rupees. Okay. Money earned in 5 months. You write here money earned in 5 months is equal to how many rupees? Rupees 75,000. Clear? In 5 months, money earned in 5 months is rupees 75,000. So we find here money earned in 1 month 1 month is equal to what? Money earning 1 month is equal to 75,000 by 5. Then you get here, if you divide 75,000 by 5, then you obtain 15,000 rupees. It means that you can see man earn 1 month 15,000 rupees. Okay, so first question arises here. What is the first question? First question arises here, and that question asks how much will he earn in 9 months? So you write here, money earned in 9 months is equal to money earned in 9 months is equal to 9 into rupees 15,000. Why multiply 15,000 by 9? Because here you find the man earned in 1 month, the earning in 1 month of the man is 15,000 rupees. Here you need to find money earned by the man 9,000. This is equal to 9 into 15,000. Okay? So it becomes, if you multiply it, 15,000 by 9, so you get 1,35,000. Okay, 1,35,000 rupees. Money earned in 9 months. Okay, and next question, it asks to us that in how many months will he earn 45,000 rupees? Okay, so number of month we find. Okay, number of month he earn 45. So number of month, you write here, number of month is equal to rupees 45,000. Okay, divide by rupees 15,000. So why you divide 45,000 by 15,000? This is because we need to find in how many months the man earned 45,000, and what is this 15,000? 50,000 represent here the man earned in 1 month 15,000 rupees. So number of months to earn 50,000 rupees is, you will find in how many months man earned 45,000 rupees. Okay, so if you divide 45,000 by 15,000, then you get 3 months. Okay, then you get 3 months. You can get 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 15, 30, 45. This is called 3 months. Clear? So student, I hope all of you understood this question. In this question, this is given that a man earns 75,000 rupees in 5 months. Question asked to us, how much will he earn in 9 months? And second question is that, in how many months will he earn 45,000 rupees? So for this, first you find the man earn in 1 month. So here you can see, you find 15,000 rupees man earn per month. Okay, so in 9 months, what amount he earned in 9 months? So if you multiply 15,000 by 9, then you get 1,35,000 rupees. It means that man can earn in 9 months is 1,35,000 rupees. Next question. Next question asked to us, in how many months man earn 45,000 rupees? So obviously, in the variable, the earning of man in 1 month is 15,000 money. If you divide 45,000 by 15,000, then you get 3 months. So we get 3 months. It means that the man earned in 3 months
of 45 rupees. Okay, now student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 4. What happened question number 4? Let's see. Now next question is given here. 6 men pay 312 parcel per day. 6 men pay 312 parcel per day. Find the number of parcel packed by 11 men per day. So let's see how to solve this question. Okay, in this question this is given that 6 men can parcel 312 parcel per day. So 11 men can be packed the parcel. How many parcel packed by 11 men per day? Okay, so let's see how to solve the question number of 4. Okay, now so here we write question number 4. In this question this is given 6 men pack parcel, number of parcel packed by 6 men. Okay, so you can write 312. Here you write here number of parcel, number of parcels packed by 6 men. How many parcel packed by 6 men? 312. 312. This is clear? Now, so number of parcel packed by 1 man. Okay, here I write number of parcel packed by 1 man is equal to 312 by 6. If we divide, see after 6, 5 is 30 and 6 to the 12, 52. If we divide 312 by 6, so you can write here 6, 5 is 30, here 31, can see, and you can bring down this to here, it will come to 6 to the 12. Clear? So can see. Okay, it means that here you can see one man can pack 52 parcel per day. This is clear. Now we need to find that 11 men will pack how many parcel per day packed by 11 men. Okay, so here you write number of parcel, number of parcel, number of parcels packed by 11 men per day is equal to 52 into 11. This is equal to what? If you multiply this, 11 to 22, 11 have 55. So here you can see 11 to 22, 11 have 55, 57. So you can see the 11 men can make parcel 572 per day. So then I hope all of understood this question. Okay, so now we are going to discuss next question. What is next question? Let's see. So student, we are going to discuss next question. Question number 5. Question number 5 is, if the cost of 7 meter cloth is 1470 rupees, find the cost of 5 meter cloths. Okay, so let's see how to solve these questions. In this question, this is given that the
cloth of 7 meter is the cost of 7 meter cloth is 1400.
70 rupees.
Okay. So you need to find cost of
5 meter cloth. Then we use electric method to find the cost of 5 meter cloth. Okay. So first we write here cost of 7 meter cloth is equal to 1.
A cost of 7 meter cloth is equal to rupees 1470.
This is given 1470 rupees given. This is the cost of 7 meter cloth. So we find here cost of 1 meter cloth.
So you can write here cost of 1 meter cloth. This is equal to rupees 1470 divided by 7. So this is equal to, you can write 7 to the 14, 7 to the 7 and a 0. So in this way,
we find the cost of 1 meter cloth. This is equal to 210 rupees. Now, we am going to find the cost of 5 meter cloth.
Okay, so here we write, therefore, cost of 5 meter cloth, 5 meter cloth is equal to what? Cost of 5 meter cloth is equal to 5 into rupees 210. Okay, why multiply
5 by 210? Because 210 rupees is the cost of 1 meter cloth. Okay, if you multiply 210 by 5, then you get cost of 5 meter cloth.
Okay, so here you can write, this becomes 5 into 0, 0, 5 on the 5 into 10. So we find the cost of 5 meter cloth is 1050 rupees.
At last you can write here,
therefore rupees 1050 is the cost of 5 meter.
I hope all of you understood these questions. Now I repeat this question again. In this question, this is given that if the cost of 7 meter cloth is rupees 1470, find the cost of 5 meter cloth. Okay, so for this, first we find the cost of 1 meter cloth. This is equal to 210 rupees. You can see here after this. We multiply 210 by 5, then you get cost of 5 meter cloth. This is equal to 1050 rupees. Cost of 5 meter cloth is 1050 rupees. So student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 6. What have you question number 6? Question number 6 has Ekta earns 3000 rupees in 10 days. Ekta earns 3000 rupees in 10 days. How much will she earn in 30 days? Is clear? So you can write here Ekta earn money earned by Ekta in 10 days. This is equal to 3000 rupees. So money earned by Ekta in 1 day. This is equal to 3000 by 10. After this, you find the money earned by Ekta in 30 days. So let's see how to solve this question.
Okay, now this is question number 5. Now we are going to discuss question number 6. What has been question number 6? You can see
question number 6, this is given. Ekta earned money in 10 days. Here you write money earned by Ekta in 10 days. Money earned by Ekta in 10 days is equal to rupees 3000. Money earned by Ekta in 10 days is equal to 3000. So we write here money earned by Ekta in 1 day is equal to rupees 3000 by 10. Then we get here rupees 300. Okay, this is given. And the money earned by Ekta in 10 days, this is equal to how many rupees? 3000 rupees. So you find here money earned by Ekta in 1 day. So you find here 300 rupees. Now we need to find money earned by Ekta in 30 days. Here we write money earned by Ekta in how many days? 30 days. 30 days is equal to 30 into 300 rupees. 300. When multiply 30 by 300, Ekta earned money in 1 day is 300 rupees. So you need to find the how many amount of money Ekta earned in 30 days. So you multiply 30 into 300. This is equal to what? This is equal to, you can say, 900. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 0. 3 and 9. So in this way, you can see, we find the money earned by Ekta in 30 days. This is equal to 9,000. In this question, this is given that the Ekta earned money in 10 days is 3000 rupees. We need to find the money earned by Ekta in 30 days. So first we find the money earned by Ekta in 1 day. This is equal to 300 rupees. After we multiply money earned by Ekta in 1 day into 30, then we get money earned by Ekta in 30 days, this is equal to 900 rupees. Student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now, we are going to discuss next questions. Next question is that the cost of, next question is question number 7. Question number 7 is given here. The cost of 4 dozen banana is 150 rupees. Cost of 4 dozen banana. Cost of 4 dozen banana is 180 rupees. Okay. So how many banana you can find in 90 rupees? Similarly, you can write it if you divide both sides by 2. So you have 2 dozen banana is equal to 90 rupees. Okay. So this question you can solve very easily. Or you can find first the cost of 1 banana. After this, you divide cost of 90 by cost of 1 banana, then you get the number of banana bought in 90 rupees, then you get 24 banana, or you can say 2000 banana. Okay, so student, I hope all of you understood this question. And the next question is that the weight of 72 kg, 72 books in 9 kg. Okay, this is given here.
the weight of 72 kg 72 books in 9 feet.
So find the weight of such 40 books. Okay,
72 kg, 72 books have 9 kg, 72 books have 9 kg. So 40 books is equal to how many? What is the weight of 40 books? So 9 kg, here you can see 5 kg. So up to 5 kg.
Okay, so I repeat this question. The weight of 72 books is 9 kg. What is the weight of 40 such books? So 9 by 72 into 40, this is equal to 5 kg. So then I hope all of you understood this question. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.